still not clear on it. When we sit here with you, and I've been with a couple of other ministers, and when we sit, the underlying peace, I recognize it as, here is this underlying peace again. And it has the same quality with a couple other masters I've been with this, as the quality of the peace that's here, where we sit with our eyes closed and just keep quiet. And yet, when you're, and some of them give emphasis to that, and it attracts the attention. The attention goes to that peace rather than outwards to thought. But when you talk about it, you say that peace that's so tangible is still just an expression. It's just another expression because it's an object, I guess, so it's an expression. But it seems that in the presence of great masters, that peace is there, and yet I think you're saying, okay, when it's there, just enjoy it when it's there, because it's going to go away anyways. Could you say something more about this peace? People with Bhagwan used to experience that peace, and then they go home and say, well, it's gone now. Could you say something more about what this peace is? Because many people give emphasis to that, or give importance to it. So I was wondering if you could talk a bit about that, what that is.
But anyhow, that is yet happening. Whatever it is yet happening, sometimes some good emotion, good feeling, peace, anything may happen.
Yeah.
In that circumstance, in good circumstances, good emotion, good vibration may be there.
Yeah.
Just like a peace or anything. But you know, on our path, what is that is the main goal. Because when we are having interested in that peace, then naturally we'll select a state. So the selecting a good state alone is the problem.
That's the problem.
But actually, thereby we are taking some responsibility in our action. Actually, there may be a state. There are many states, some pleasurable state, sometimes we may have peace, either we may have some another experience, just like bliss consciousness itself may happen. We cannot say that anything may happen. But that is not important. That is not important.
So what is it? Why does it seem to happen in the presence of a master, where all of a sudden space is here, everyone is quiet, most people are experiencing it, if you talk to them, what is it?
It may be that, it may be related to the quality of the master or quality of the listeners, both may have importance. But the main role is that, is in our part. So quality may be there, doesn't matter, but this quality will not give you the real change.
The real
change is in our hand.
Yeah.
For example, if the master has a quality that creates some vibration, so on the timing it will be all
right.
Whenever you are in the spell of the good vibration, you will be all right. But whenever you come away from the boundary, you will be again in the old way of body. So here the main thing is that whether we have to take any responsibility on our part or not. So the responsible position, whenever we want to maintain or get something, we take a responsible role. So psychologically, all responsibility is a burden. So no responsibility should be taken. Everything, whatever happened, let it happen on its own.
Right.
The external world is alone concerned. We have to take responsibility. The responsibility is related to the external world. Psychologically, we must be most irresponsible. The irresponsible thing alone is the good thing.
So when it's there, enjoy it. When it's gone, doesn't matter.
So everything is a natural. Whenever we try to get it forever or trying to maintain the state forever, then we create some responsibility for ourselves. But now when we take some responsibility, the ego, the I am, is the I consciousness is strengthened. So, but in the external world is concerned, the responsibility, the I consciousness is justified. But psychologically it is not justified.
So you don't give any importance to teaching in silence?
Only for the beginners though. Beginners, everything is nice, everything is good. Because they are preparing themselves to reach the liberation point of view. When we consider liberation always the highest thing, then no practice is necessary, no following is necessary. So actually, we have to give up everything. When there is no following, then only the liberation is there. Otherwise, whenever we are having some following, whenever we are having some philosophy in our hand, we are having some responsibility, we are having some boundary. So whenever we are free, no boundary is there, no following is there, no philosophy is there. We have to be free. No work is there. That is alone is the sumayur. Sumayur, doing nothing.
Sumayur,
doing nothing.
Then that itself become a philosophy.
So if it takes,
we have to put some effort to become the sumayur, nothingness.
So whenever you are taking effort to be in the nothing state, it again a philosophy.
Yeah, that's okay. Now that's what I come to say. But the problem itself that we know the degree that we have to be. Nothingness state, but for that unknowingly we are putting effort to that. How to avoid that effort?
So here, whatever happened in the psychological world, we have to take it as unconscious one. Even though it looks like a conscious effort, even though you are following some philosophy or not, we have to take it as unconscious happening. We have to name it as unconscious happening. Then only it will be all right.
Yeah. Again, when we talk about unconscious happening, if we talk something about psychological things, that is again effort.
So here, whenever you take some responsibility to change anything, because something has happened, whether conscious happening or conscious doing or not, but you are doing something. But do you think you are committing a mistake and afterwards you are taking some decision not to commit a mistake? So, here whatever happens in the psychological world, you have to give total consent to that. We should not hold yourself responsible for any wrong committed by you. You have to, that means you commit as many wrong as possible. You are having the total right to commit wrong within yourself.
Yeah.
So you can commit wrong.
What you are saying is correct, but from the beginning, like I am 53, the society or me, myself, has built up certain things saying that you have to do this way, that way. Okay, that I cannot eradicate just like that. Am I correct or not? Psychologically, I have built up. Already, both for 53 years, I have certain ideas, certain ideologies, certain philosophy, everything. Now, all of a sudden, if you ask me to just observe it or just take it easy, at that time, I cannot do that. I could not do that. That's the reason. What you are saying is correct, but it's not allowing me to do that.
So
how to come out of that?
So you have some philosophy and you cannot follow the philosophy, you cannot execute the philosophy successfully. So something happens beyond your philosophy.
That's your concern.
So you accept that. So if something is happening psychologically, so it is not under your control. That is the evidence that it is not under your control. So you totally accept that.
Yeah. Now that it become again a philosophy. Accept it again. See, I want to accept it. It's not that I don't want
to
accept
it. So here, whatever it may be, so whatever you are doing in the psychological world, you may take it as a wrong. Let it be a wrong doer. You openly admit you are wrong doing. So psychologically, you must be in a correct way. You keep yourself to do a correct thing alone. So psychologically you have no work. In spite of your understanding that you have no work is needed, in spite of that you do something with some philosophy of God. But let it be whatever happens in the psychological world, you are not in a position to measure you. You have no right to question anything. So you are in an unquestionable state. Whatever you do, it may be wrong, let it be wrong.
Yeah. There I could not answer. There the not. Actually, I could not accept it as, okay, let it happen. This is wrong, let it happen. That acceptance is not coming to
me. So what else you have to do?
Yeah, that's what I'm asking. With the problem itself, see, actually, I read most of your books. It's very good, actually, but there is a similar line.
You are trying to execute a philosophy in the psychological world. Mm-hmm. That alone is the problem. So you are trying to execute the problem.
Yeah, how to come out of that problem? The question is, I know that there is a problem. So here, how to come out? I can't do that.
Don't try to execute the problem consciously. That is alone is the thing. So in spite of your understanding, something happens, you consider it as unconscious happening. Because you are on your part, you have no idea to execute a philosophy within the psychological world. But in spite of that, if you try to execute the philosophy, means that has to be done without your effort. It has to happen, it has to be treated as a happening. Because on your part you have no idea to execute any effort. But in spite of that you are doing something, means it is beyond your control. So accept it is going beyond your control.
He has to accept that he can't accept. I can't accept, that's what I mean. The problem is I can't accept that. How to accept it? How to accept it?
Again you are asking your philosophy.
Yeah, again that's the problem issue.
Again you ask your philosophy to execute.
The problem is simply what I am facing, but I could maybe a lot of people might be facing.
So your question is demand for another philosophy.
Yeah, that's what is coming. How to accept it again? I could not accept it, that's all.
So here, you will come to a conclusion, no work, even in the in a state where we cannot take a decision, you take it as a natural one. So here is that you have to tan your face from there, because whenever you tan your face there, you will find some fault and want to correct something. So you have no right to measure yourself psychologically. So whenever you are measuring yourself, naturally you will have an idea to correct the thing, because you will find fault with that. Whenever you are measuring yourself, you will find a fault with yourself. Then you have to try to correct yourself. So here the measuring creates problem itself. So we have no right to measure you psychologically. If you measure, you want to say everything is correct. And even when you want to do your philosophy, and if you are executive philosophy, you can executive philosophy by giving total acceptance to everything, accept everything, whatever happens, let it happen. You may then you in course of time it will be all right. But as a practice, you can do like this. Actually, no practice is necessary, but in spite of that, we unconsciously we want some practice. We may do like this. Whatever you are having, you give total full consent to that. Everything is happening naturally. You may go along with that. And course of time, everything will operate on its own.
So you said turn your face from that. You said, so turn your face from that. So where do we turn our face to? There, So you see that?
The circumstances alone, the real world is the external world.
Right.
So there we can have many things to face, yes. But psychologically it's only the reaction. Where we are existing is the actual world. This is only a shadow or an illusion, yeah. It's a reaction. And when we are interested upon the images on the illusion and the shadow, then we want to have the intention to correct the shadows.
Yeah. I think that's why the silence seems so is so attractive, because when the silence is there, there's no interest in the psychological state. But, and I'd like to come back to what's your name?
Asaf.
Asaf. Mm. To what Asaf said, he asked, so you don't pay any attention or give any importance to teachings in silence. And yet that was what he asked. And with Ramana, they thought like this is the highest teaching, is the teaching in silence. That's what he said, the highest teaching is the teaching in silence. So there's that attraction to that silence. And but yeah, I know if I could sit quietly, I can meditate and sit quietly for 1,000 years and I'm going to be liberated, I know that. But you're not giving attention to it, yet Ramana said it's the highest teaching, the teaching in silence. So, and when you come here and you sit here and we're silent, I think there's a deep love for that silence. And so I guess that's the attraction to it. So I was wondering if you could say something about that. Ramana is saying that the teaching in silence is the highest teaching. He talks like that anyways.
The persons may be benefited, but it will not give you an understanding. Mm-hmm. The understanding is only in the intellectual world.
Right.
You have to have a conclusion intellectually. Then only, because all problem is intellectual. So the silence is not related to the intellectual problem.
Right, I understand that. So that's why a person could sit in silence and go away and everything's still the same, because the understanding isn't there.
But in the silence, maybe all right for the time being.
Yeah.
But after never come away from the silence, you'll once again be in the old track.
Same
old thing. When we have the proper understanding, then we need not worry about anything. Whether silence is there or not, we don't bother about
right.
that. Everything will be all right.
So in the same way, there's not much importance to the energy of the mountain or anything like that. It's again just an experience, just a happening that may occur and doesn't bring any understanding.
No, yeah. We will have some persons, we may have some good feeling for the time being. But the intellectual understanding, it will remain with you forever. If you have the proper understanding in the intellectual level, it is yours. Becomes the main thing is the knot is in the intellectual level. So we have to open the knot and the matter will be completely over. So we need, but wherever you are, the understanding will be with you. But we cannot take the mountain always along with you. But we can take the understanding wherever you go, the understanding will follow you.
It made me think that the fact that understanding is the most important thing and from there everything follows, that if something happens and there is some damage to the brain because of anything, and the intellect in a way damaged, there's some damage, so the intellect doesn't work properly and understanding maybe, I don't know if it will be still there. And the question is there, if I understand correctly, liberation is you are liberated from any circumstances, whether no matter what happened physically also. But if there is some damage, for example, to this intellect, and it doesn't function properly, how then you will be free in such a situation?
So here, the intellect is not, we are not demanding greater intelligence. So intellect means we understand no work in the psychological world. So simple understanding. Because we are accustomed to take some responsibility in the external world, we apply the same rules psychologically also. And where we are finding to have a comfortable place in the psychological world. And we are, for that reason alone, we are inquiring here and there. But the simple understanding that we have no work there, that alone is enough. And we have to understand, and we must be sure that our understanding is correct. And then afterwards, the conclusive understanding will take care of itself. But this is very, but you need not always remain with the understanding, always keep the understanding with you. Once you have decided, then you keep yourself without having any disturbance by the other school of thought or anything. But somebody may say, no, you have to do something, some work, then only you will be all right. So they may say like this. But they are doing that probably for the beginners. For the beginners it is inevitable. Because some doing, some work, some practice, everything is good. Then only they can be all right to reach the higher level. So in that higher level, the little understanding that we have no work psychologically is enough. And it will not be damaged by anything. So it will be damaged by the other school of thought alone. Otherwise it is not, it will not be damaged.
And the relationship between the experiencer and the I sense. We have an I sense, Ahankar. We call it as Ahankar. What is the difference between this experiencer and this Ahankara? And one more relationship is the consciousness, I. Is there, what is that?
So, whenever we experience the Ahankara or experiencer, we can experience only the experiencer alone. There cannot be any state in the name of Ahankara. So it will express itself only in the form of some experiencer. It will take always in the role of experiencer. It can never strike the pure Ahankara itself. Whenever we feel something as Ahankara or anything, it is also an experiencer. It is experiencing something. They feel that it is experiencing something. Whenever we have some feeling of the Ahankara itself, the I consciousness itself, there will be a sense of experiencing something.
Something.
It will be there.
So, so it again appears and disappears according to the experience.
Can you
say like that?
Oh, yeah. But here, instead of, for example, you close your eyes and watch your eye consciousness itself, but even watching your eye consciousness itself and you are having some pure Ahankara itself, even it is in that case also, so it can be considered as the experience of himself itself. He is experiencing himself. But not the other thing, but he is experiencing himself.
So this eye consciousness is the background and this experiencer appears and disappears. Can we say like this?
But apart from the experiencer, there cannot be any Ahankara. So Ahankara itself, the eye consciousness itself.
You are calling Ahankara as consciousness?
Ahankara and consciousness are same. Even though these things also takes the role of our experiencer. So whenever we to give a meaning to or give a name to the name of experience, Ahankara, there cannot be anything. There cannot be any eye consciousness.
No, eye consciousness, but that is called the eye sense.
So whenever you feel the eye sense, that is an eye experience.
Experience, okay.
We can feel only the experience.
Experience.
we cannot feel the eye consciousness alone. No. So whenever we may think that the eye consciousness is always there, and for the eye consciousness, the experiencer comes again and again. That is not the case. Only the experiencer alone coming again and again. No, not apart from that, there is no eye consciousness. We know, we feel only the experiencer.
Experiencer.
And the experience may take the role of eye consciousness. But it may take himself time, the eye consciousness. It may take like this. But it is also still, it is an experiencer.
There is no object involved in that experience. He himself thinks.
Oh, yeah.
He said there's no object. How?
Object means he himself becomes the object and subject. He is both object and subject.
Okay.
The experiencing, some experiencing is happening. The experiencing itself contains the subject and object.
Right,
okay. Once it can be considered as subject and as well as object also.
Mm-hmm. I was wondering, how can there be an experiencer without an object of some sort?
Yeah.
The experiencer needs an object to be an experiencer.
But here, the feeling of eye consciousness, because when you're watching the eye consciousness itself, the eye consciousness is the object and the watcher is a subject, so both are same.
Right.
This experiencer and experiences is being normally referred as mind. America. We are talking about experience of the mind.
Mind.
Yeah.
Mind.
But sometimes I also say that there is a problem in my mind. Then who is experiencing that?
So it is a terminology. The terminology will be like that. As I am, because when I watch myself, so I am is separate to watch myself means there are two I am is not there, but the terminology is like that. I am watching myself means the watcher is one thing and the watched is another thing, that is not the thing. Mm-hmm. So in this way, every terminology will have the thing, because we have to use some terminology like that. As you are using some terminology, there cannot be any different things. As we are watching my mind, or there, when I refer that I have mind, that does not mean apart from the mind I am existing. Mm-hmm. But actually, I am the product of the mind itself.
Mind itself.
I am the part of the mind itself. Everything is what we feel, everything is the total whole of the mind, one part of the mind.
தேவையில்லை எதுவுமே தேவையில்லை, இது எப்படி இருந்தாலும் ஓகேங்கிற ஒரு கான்செப்ட் வந்தாச்சுன்னு சொன்னால்
அதுக்கப்புறம் உங்களுக்கு எதுனாலும் ஓகே தானே, எதுனாலும் ஓகேங்கும் போது நீங்கள் சமாதானமாக இருந்தாலும் ஓகே தான், சண்டை போட்டாலும் ஓகே தானே. அங்கே வந்து தப்புன்ட்டே ஒன்றுமே கிடையாது. சைக்கலாஜிக்கல் ஆஸ்பெக்டை பொறுத்தளவில் தப்புன்னுட்டே ஒன்றுமே கிடையாது, எல்லாமே கரெக்டு தான் சொல்லும்போது நீங்கள் என்னொன்னு தான் பண்ணிக்கலாமே. நீங்கள் பயிற்சி பண்ணாலும் சரி, பயிற்சி பண்ணாமல் இருந்தாலும் சரி, ஒரு ஃபிலாசபி எடுத்தாலும் சரி, எடுக்காமல் இருந்தாலும் சரி, ஆனால் உங்களுக்கு எல்லாமே ரைட்டு அது, எதுவுமே தப்பு கிடையாது.
நினச்சிக்கிட்டது தெரியுது எல்லாம் ஏகா வரும், அது ஒன்றும் செய்ய முடியாது, புரிஞ்சுக்கிட்டேன். அது மீறியுமா இருக்கிறத கையெழுத்துக்கூடாது நீங்கள் சொல்லியிருக்கேன், அது கையெழுத்துக்கா சொல்லியிருக்கேன். அதை நான் ட்ரை பண்ணும்போது சில பேர் சொல்லும்போது தான் சொல்கிறாங்க, அது வந்து நீங்கள் ஒரு முயற்சியாக கொண்டாந்துருக்கிறேன். இப்போ நீங்கள் இப்போ சொல்கிறது தான் கரெக்ட், புரியுது
எதுவுமே நமக்கு அதில் வந்து இதுதான் கரெக்டான ஸ்டேட்டில் இருக்கிறோம், நம்ம இப்போ இருக்கிறது தான் கரெக்டான ஸ்டேட்டு, இப்போ தப்பு நினைச்சுட்டு நம்ம ஒரு ஸ்டேட்டே கிடையாது. எந்த
ஸ்டேட் நீ எடுத்தாலும் ப்ராப்ளம் எடுக்கிறாங்க, அப்படி யூஸ் பண்ணுவோம். ஓகே, கையில் எடுக்காமல் இருக்கிறதுன்றதுன்னா இட் இஸ் நாட் எ எஃபர்ட், இட் இஸ் திஸ் ஆல்சோ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங் தட் நீ எடுத்தாலும் எடுக்கலாம். அது ஒன்று
வி எக்ஸ்பெக்ட் ஏ ரிசல்ட் ஃப்ரம் தட், ஆல் எஃபர்ட் எக்ஸ்பெக்ட் ஏ ரிசல்ட். ஸோ ஹியர் வென் யூ டேக் எவ்ரி திங் இஸ் கரெக்ட், தென் தெர் இஸ் நோ எஃபர்ட் இஸ் நீடட். ஸோ சம் ராங் இஸ் தேர், தென் ஒன்லி வீல் ஹேவ் சம் எஃபர்ட். ஸோ எஃபர்ட் இஸ் ரிக்வயர்ட். So whatever happening in the psychological world is correctly happening. That alone we have to accept the correctness of the happening. So we should not take something is wrong. Whenever we find some wrong in the psychological world, then only the effort is coming. So whatever happened, we have to take as a correct thing. So we have to accept in the total psychological world, let's say our total world. When we think this is wrong, this is right, we make it different. We are creating some division in the psychological world. So psychological world must be taken as a total world. So there should not division in the psychological world.
In this, even though we don't take it as a good or bad, but it is disturbing, you know, inside, a bit of frustration, fear and all this, even though it will be, even if you take it as a good or bad, let us assume that you don't take it as good or bad, but it is affecting us inside, it is burning. How to come out of that? It is prolonged, the period of the prolongation is there, it keeps burning, you know, like something happens, something wrong things is happening, somebody is betrayed you or something like that. Good or bad, leave it on. But the feeling and the change happening in your body and the chemical reactions, it's there all the time.
So whenever you want to come out of something, then you are naming it as a bad thing. Then only you want to come away from that.
No, I don't want to come out, but it is happening. I
got so happening, let it be. So
no, but it's not, I don't ask. That feeling itself, it is killing me. It's like
so, we have to take this as a natural thing. It may kill you, it may harm you. Let it be the natural, because we cannot, we have no right to question it. So it is raining, it is some thunderfall is there, some wind is flowing, we cannot question it. This is the natural happening. So in this way, whatever happens in the psychological world, we have to take this as a natural thing.
We could not take that as a natural thing. See, something I'm normal now. Some phone call is coming, somebody is disturbing me.
So, whenever you, for example, if you want a practice, you do it as a practice. If you are able to maintain you without practice, then you can, very understanding is enough. So, whenever his understanding is not enough, he can go on for a practice.
So, what sort of practice?
So, there are many school of meditation, yoga. Thereby you can protect yourself without having any problem. But if you, for the sort of period alone, it will give you some salvation. But after that, it will be once again in the same way. But there are many, see, all meditations are only for that. You can arrest yourself, you can lock yourself within the period, within the place. But we do not, for the time being it will be alright. But we cannot protect you only with the help of meditation. with some practice. So
that means initially you recommend us to go for some meditation sort of thing.
So because you whenever you want to control yourself, then you have to take the measure of controlling yourself. So if you able to take it as a natural thing, then practice is not necessary. But when you need practice, you have to do practice.
Until I could able to take it as a natural thing, I do this practice.
Yeah, yeah.
Once I can able to take it as a natural thing,
so
then
you have, not only that, you have, if you understand the fault of the practice, if you realize that it is helpless, when you understand all practice are helpless to solve the problem perfectly, then you will be free from the practice.
No, I can't say that this all practices are waste. For example, I can use.
For the beginners it is good, but how long you have to be a beginner?
No, not like that. Like anger, a small example, anger. When somebody, if I get anger due to certain reasons, that goes prolonged for a day, like that, day, weeks. But when after doing the practice, it stays normally just half an hour. Even sometimes it's just like that, 5 minutes, I forget, okay, this is not like, okay, take it. So, the 2 days, 3 days period, it has become half an hour now. That one gave the practice because of the regular silence, sitting in meditation. So, I keep, I see it as a very good progress. See, what I feel, now it become 2 days to five, half an hour, still continue that same practice, it may become another 20 minutes, again another 5 minutes, maybe after some time it may nullify. That's what I understood. But now, where this it comes actually, take it easy policy.
So here, if you, for example, if you use the practice, keep some meditation, keep the silence, and it may help. Whenever you are in the energy field of some practice, it will protect you. But whenever you are away from the energy field, you cannot always keep you with the energy field. So for the timing alone, it can be...
No, I'm talking about even in our office. There's no energy field, I'm not meditating, I'm doing the office hours. Earlier, my boss shouts me, I get angry and 2 days, he's a big man, I have to, Now, I could have just, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, okay, that is his nature. Accept it. That it has become 2 hours, 3 hours anger towards my boss. It has become 20 minutes to half an hour. This is not, I'm not in the environment that actually it is protecting me. My inside itself, when that happens, okay, then when I come back, immediately I realize something, okay, let it happen. What is going to happen? Let us see tomorrow. Keep this job, let us do it tomorrow. See, that sort of understanding has come because of small practices.
So here you are having some arrangement to the work. So you have to take other people, how to involve the people, how to take the anger, the person of angry. So it is some arrangement of work. So this arrangement of work will also give you some solution. Because whenever you take the person in a negative way, it will give some negative feeling. If you take him as a positive way, some positive feeling alone can. That is the arrangement of work alone. But sometimes, without no reason, because externally you have power, but psychologically you may have some power. But in psychological problem like thing, for that reason, if you do some practice, you cannot have such kind of emotion like this.
Yeah, but now we cannot actually completely distinguish between external and internal. See, when the boss shouts, that is external. When it comes to me, it is agitation because I cannot shout against him or something. Okay, when I come back, it becomes internal to me. It starts burning inside me. So, you cannot distinguish completely external and internal. It is all interlinked.
So, you have told that the boss is in all the way like that, so you need not worry about that. So he accept his nature, his temperament will be like that, I have to adjust with him. If you, that means you have some positive approach with your boss. So in that case, thereby you are keeping yourself, even though he is shouting in angry words, that is natural. If you accept like this, then if you accept like this, you will not have any emotion within you.
Yeah,
so this is a positive approach to the circumstances.
Acceptance, how it came means, it's not directly just like it came. It's actually after going to the silence and coming to this type of Thiruvannamalai and meeting the people like you. So, other persons, I'm taking certain, maybe I feel that I'm taking, they are purifying myself, not the world. See, it has come, as I said, the duresness come down now. Really, I feel that the duresness come down. Maybe the same thing which I made, the positive approach, positive meditation, that duration may come still further from that down. One time I may feel that, okay, that's all, accept it. See, the practice has given me so much. That's what I feel that.
What practice you are meaning?
Just me meditating and keeping my silent.
So here you are accepting the boss along with his temperament. So for that the meditation is helpful.
Yes, that's what I meant to say.
So let it be. if it is helping, you can make use of that.
That's correct. Where it comes, the intellectual understanding which you are talking, you know. Intellectually understand that initially itself, boss is like that, accept it.
So this is also the translation with the external world. So the external world, how we have to behave in the external thing, that is different. But how we have to behave within yourself is different. So my understanding is like to how you have to behave with yourself. You are accepting that the angry nature is the temperament of the boss. You accept him as it is. So in this way, you may have some romantic expression within your psychological structure. You have to accept your mind as the character of the mind itself. So you may, as you accept your boss, you have to accept your mind itself. So that is the understanding that I am trying to convey.
Yeah. Yeah, but again, we are actually most of the issues comes to us, the psychological issues comes to us due to the society outside world. Inside, actually, when you are in Thiruvan, actually, when I came here last 2 days, I did not get any calls or anything. I am peace. No problems. Except go to temple, go to Arunachalam Shape, no problem. Once I get a call out of this area that is mentioned, I will start coming, go to the outside world now. Okay? Then there only the problem starts and where there only the psychological impact start coming inside. Until that time, no problems. So where, see, we have to tackle both. We cannot say that, okay, outside world, let it happen, whatever it happens, you be inside, it's not possible. Outside world reacts and only affecting more than my inside world.
So let it be.
Yeah.
Because you have affected psychologically. For here, something happened, something called you through phone, so you have some psychological problems. So the problem, you create some problems psychologically. The outside call creates a problem psychologically.
Yes.
So psychologically means, what you have to do psychologically? So you have to take this natural thing. We should not question it.
No, there's a news which is coming over the phone. It is disturbing you.
So how?
It's disturbing you. Exactly. So there could be anything.
Because the society is disturbing us.
Yes.
So we have to go, get away from the society.
So
society will be there. The circumstances will be there. But here, that will be the nature of the thing. But the nature of our mind is also getting disturbed. Is the nature of our mind. So we have to accept the nature of the mind itself. We have to wholeheartedly accept the nature of the mind, then we will not fight with our mind. But what I am trying to say is that don't fight with your mind. You may fight with your neighbor, you can fight with this boss, you can fight with the circumstances, that is the justification. And then there is some sense. Doesn't matter that you should not fight illegally. You can have a legal arrangement for that. But don't fight with the universe. Psychologically, if you are finding fault with yourself, is the reason for fighting with yourself. So psychologically, you are all right. Well, even though you are, you feel you are not all right, but we have to take it as a right thing. So psychologically, it's a natural because it is not in our hand. Something happens unconsciously. So whatever it is happening in the psychological world, this happens on its own. If it is in our hand, we will keep our mind always in a good state. So as we cannot keep it in a good state, naturally it is out of our control. So we have to take it as a natural thing. What is not under our control, we have to take it as a natural one. So when we take it as a natural, it is meaningless to fight with the natural.
That through meditation we can create a sattvic state. It seems that the mind can become sattvic, but that too is temporary. So I can meditate, and then, like he's saying, my boss doesn't bother me because I might be in a sattvic state as a result of the meditation, but that too is temporary. It's not the duration.
Comparing the understanding, it will have some little use. It will have some use. Some meditation, some arrangement, it will give you some good result. But when you are liberated, you are eternally free from your mind. So that is the thing.
That's the itself. It's a movement in the mind which tries to attain something. So even to attain better understanding. And if my understanding is correct, this need, once the understanding is there, you see that you don't need this desire at all. But still, I see that my actions are still motivated by this desire. Coming here to Tirvana Marai, or coming to Satsang, or reading, or whatever. So I wonder if I need this action, to let go even of this action, or consider this action our subconscious, I don't know. Because if the understanding is there, there would be no need to do any of this stuff. And I find myself still doing it. So I wonder if you talk about it.
So here, we are not ready to accept ourselves. Because each and every moment we are in some state. But we are not ready to accept this state, where we are now. So we want to change this state. So then only all effort comes. So whatever you are doing, whatever you are thinking, whatever you are experiencing, whatever you are doing, in a given moment you are in a state of mind. So we think that this is not the correct state. Where we are now is not the correct state. Then only all the effort comes. So when you are in the highest state, even though it may be some wrong feeling, it may be some agony or anything, this is the reality, because this alone has the expression of itself. All other state is an imaginary state. So this alone is the real state. So what is real is the truth and everything. But we are after the unreality, we are after the reality is the actual thing. But we are interested upon the unreal thing. But if you are interested upon the real thing, then we have to go along with the real thing. So real thing is the happening. What is happening, it may look bad, it may look some insufficient, but it is the reality. So what we are having in our mind, in our expression, in our experience is the real thing. The real thing alone have existence. The other thing is it does not have any existence. But we think, we demand. So all our demand disturb the actual happening of this thing. So for accepting ourselves, we need not have any demand. So here, if we understand that nothing is needed in the psychological world, all our demand is against the natural thing, against the reality, then only we have no other goal except to accept what is happening psychologically. So here, when it is no work is needed here, we need not pay attention to all those things. Whatever happens, whenever our attention is needed, some work is there. If there is no work here, we need not pay attention constantly. So even paying constant attention to the psychological world is also creating problems. So to the understanding level itself, it is afterwards, whether you pay attention or not, you will be conscious of the happening. It doesn't matter. But at the same time, you need not pay any conscious attention to that. So when you understand like this, no work here, then you need not pay attention to that.
So, just in relation to action, the decision that I make, for example, to come here to Tiruvana Marai, I can say it's in spite of the understanding. Because the main reason for me coming here is to attain something. Otherwise, I wouldn't.
So you must be sure that no work is there. But here the disturbance happens only because of other school of thought alone.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, if you are sure that no work is in the psychological world, then there is no matter. Because you have to control yourself, you have to understand totally that no work is here. But the other school of thought may say, no, we have to do something. Then only we may have some doubt about this understanding. Otherwise, if you are sure, then no work is needed. But for that, but instead of for the reason of understanding, you need not come to Tiruvannamalai or anywhere else. But understanding is over, so by understanding no work is there. But for some other reason, you may come. Because it is beautiful, go along with many things.
You can bring many of your friends.
And if it's still happening, is it mean that the understanding is not complete or is it not integrated? Is there a phase that the understanding is there, but the action contradicts the understanding?
But when we introduce another school of thought to disturb that, you are not changing the idea. The idea may say that you have some work. But the unconscious work does not matter. For example, whenever you have some sorrow or fear, naturally we want to be free from that. That does not matter. But when you are consciously come to a conclusion that we have to do some work here, then only we are introducing another factor against the understanding. And the understanding is simple. But when we introduce some disturbance, the disturbance alone can create the problem. Otherwise, there is no problem. We need not go deeper understanding. There is no deeper understanding. All understanding is very, very superficial. The understanding is not deeper. If you trying to go deeper, that itself is the negation of understanding. So understanding is very, very superficial, very, very intellectual.
Yeah, there is some fear to drop all this search, all this seeking, let it be. I see there's some doubt or fear that says that I cannot let go now. Still, not yet. You understand?
So let go. Instead of doing let go, what else you are doing?
Sorry.
You are trying to let go anything.
Mm-hmm.
So you need not trying to let go. So let go is, if you're trying to let go, it again is a practice.
Mm-hmm.
So all practice, because it creates some end. So when you do something, then you expect something. So no expectation is necessary in the psychological world is concerned. When everything is correct, then what else you have to expect? So whatever happens, we have to take it as a natural happening. When we find some fault within ourselves, then only we have to let go or anything. If you practice something, all practice means expectation, want the expected result.
Mm-hmm.
So no result is needed. So whatever happens is the correct thing. So the labeling of everything as the correct thing or natural thing, that alone is needed.
expectation, because when you were saying, you said that something about being eternally free. Mm-hmm. And as soon as you said that, this voice came up inside me saying, but I am eternally free. I am eternally free. And yet, then this mind, and this is where I guess what you were saying to me yesterday is that even if the mind argues with that, to just see that as a happening rather than a doing, and don't even get into a fight with that. That's just a happening. Just believe when the mind, because the mind, well, I am eternally free. So where is this constant peace? Where is this constant bliss? And I don't mean a blissful state. And then so this mind, this conditioned mind that looks for something to be different than it is, and expects that even though our nature is freedom, and always has been and always will be, that it still looks for something to be a little different. And that's the, I guess, where the doubt is, or really, it's just something that I was seeing when you were saying that, because I felt that inside, I am eternally free. How can it be any other way? If it's any other way, then it's not worth it. It has to be. But yet the ideas of freedom are getting in the way of that freedom is nothing at all. The desire of the mind to make freedom an experience. Looking for some experience to say this is freedom.
But we all thinking that some kind of good experience must be always in the psychology of mind.
That's the...
But actually, the liberated mind means the natural healthy mind. For example, each and every sensory organs, it must keep without any experience. It always keep without any experience. For example, when you want to... When we are looking at the object, the next moment it will be free from the object itself. If you see, look at other object, the image will be go away. So in this way, when I hear a sound, the next moment it will be free from the sound.
Right.
So it keep ever empty in each and everything. Every time it is emptying itself. So, but the mind alone, you want to catch hold of something, some good experience I must always have. Always in the expression of the mind. It is actually our mind is also another sensory organ. But in the sensory, in the mind alone, I want to have a good experience always and want to be free from bad experience. But if you don't mind any experience, that is the natural state of our healthy mind. When it takes a tendency of selecting a good experience, then naturally it has to select the bad experience also.
Yes.
Because it tends to retain something. So that so if you are free from rejecting all experience, including the good and bad, so you may be free from the bad itself. So we must keep the mind not catching hold of any experience. So that's the natural state of our mind. It is not having any experience forever. But that means we are always in short seeking of some good experience alone.
Yeah.
The seeking good experience alone is the problem.
Right.
So if you do not seek the good experience, then you will not retain the bad experience.
And all the scriptures seem to support that eternal bliss, eternal this, eternal that. Because all the scriptures seem to give that impression.
I found that the seeking is not for a specific experience, it's for a flow of experience. You know, this is the seeking. It's another way of thinking, not for something, yeah, I know there's no good, no bad, but I want it to flow. And there is a seeking here. Not allowing the for it not to flow, to be part of the flow.
Even though you may change the name, it is against the secret of person in the name of flowing.
Yes, still seeking for some experience.
No, seeking for some good experience. Because the flowing is a good experience. Yes. So we seek that kind of flowing experience.
And it's looking for the flow to be a feeling, a good feeling, a good experience in that way, rather than what you're talking.
நல்ல எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் வருது நீங்க கெட்ட எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸும் வருது நமக்கு இந்த உணர்வுகளை வேண்டான்னு சொல்றது யாரு வேணும்னு சொல்றது யாரு வேணும்னு சொல்றது நம்ம கண்ட்ரோல் இருக்க மாதிரி நம்ம நம்ம புரிஞ்சு வச்சுட்டு இருக்கோம் இது பாட்டு வரும் போகும் நல்ல எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் வந்தாலும் கெட்ட எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் வந்தாலும் எது வந்தாலும் அது வரும் போகும் அப்படி நம்ம முடிவு பண்ணுவோம் முடிவு பண்ணல செஞ்சு வச்சுருந்தோம் இது வேணும் இது வேணாம்னு யார் முடிவு பண்ணிட்டு இருக்கிறது
என்ன
தெரியாது
தாட் ஃபார்ம்ல வந்துருது இந்த தாட் ஃபார்ம்ல வரும்பொழுது அந்த தாட் வந்து எப்பவுமே டுவேலாக தான் இருக்கும் ஒரு எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸர் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ்ங்கிற மாதிரி ஒரு டுவேலாக தான் இருக்கும் அப்போ ஒரே தாட் தான் ரெண்டு ஒரு வேலையே செய்தது ஒரு ஒரு பக்கத்தில் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் இருக்குது இன்னொரு பக்கத்தில் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் இருக்காது ரெண்டுமே தாட்டு தான்
ரெண்டு தாட்டா
ஒரே ஒரே தாட்டுக்குள்ள ரெண்டு ஒரே தாட்டுக்குள்ளே ரெண்டு பகுதி இருக்கு
அது நம்ம இயற்கை படிக்கப்படுது
அது வந்து அப்படி இருந்தால் தானே நீங்கள் வெளியுள்ளதெல்லாம் பண்ண முடியும் வெளியுள்ள வேலைகள் அப்படி பண்ண முடியும் ஒரே தாட்டுக்குள்ள ரெண்டு தாட்டுனா தான் நீங்கள் வெளியுள்ள வேலைகள் செய்ய முடியும் இது வெளியுள்ள வேலைக்காக படைக்கப்பட்டது
ஆனால் உள்ளே
நீங்கள் உள்ளுள்ள வேலைக்கே எடுத்துக்கிட்டீங்க உள்ள வந்து ரெண்டு இருந்தாலும் இங்கே ஒன்று தானே இருக்கு நீங்கள் கனவுல வந்து நீங்களும் இருக்கிறீங்க நிறைய நபர்களும் இருக்கிறாங்க அங்கே உண்மையிலே ஒவ்வொரு நேரத்துலேயும் ஒரு ஃபிரமெண்ட் ஆஃப் தாட்டு தான் இருக்குது அந்த தாட்டில் அங்கே வந்து உங்களை காட்டுறதுக்கு ஒரு கனவு உங்கள் நண்பர்களை காட்டுறதுக்கு ஒரு கனவுகள்லாம் கிடையாது ஒரே கனவு தான் நீங்கள் காட்டுது இதில் நீங்கள் உங்களை நண்பர்களெல்லாம் விட்டு உங்களை மட்டும் அப்புறப்படுத்த முடியாது ரொம்ப இருந்துகிட்டே தான் இருக்கும்
இதில்
என்னன்னு சொல்லிச்சுன்னா இந்த நாளில் கூட தப்பு இல்லை அதுக்கு நீங்கள் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி கொடுத்தீங்கன்னு சொன்னால் அந்த டுவேலிட்டி இன்னும் கொஞ்சம் அதிகமாகிடுது பொறுப்பை கொடுத்துருவீங்க இது சரி பண்ணணுங்கிற பொறுப்பை அதை கொடுத்துருவீங்க அப்போ அது வந்து தொடர்ந்து அது அந்த டுவேலிட்டி இன்னும் கொஞ்சம் ஸ்ட்ரென்தன் பண்ணியிருக்கு அப்போ போராட்டமாக இருக்குது
Morning, evening, morning, like a mukam, like a camp. We are planning this thing.
ಇಲ್ಲ ಉತ್ತಮ ನಾವು ಆಡಿಯನ್ಸೇ ಇಲ್ಲಿಯೇ
accept whatever it comes, just like that. Just I want to know, we are conducting the 4 days, 5 days, the Muhammad conduct. What we are going to get from that? Or just like that, enjoy that environment? Teaching is very simple.
We are having this group only for 2 nights satsang. And afterwards, in the meantime, I may go for the another during May, we have the Yerkad, and where we are having so only limited time, only morning hour we have session, and afterwards, only in the evening at around 7 o'clock around, we will have the meeting. Within the gap, they will go for some sightseeing or anything they do.
Because that's what I'm trying to make it. This is very simple, understand. But what we do in the Moham, that is, enjoy that environment.
Not only that. We'll have talk and discussion on various topics. Yes, we have many topics here. On many topics we can discuss. The main thing is same, but we have some connection on many ways we can connect it to this main subject.
Yeah, the core is the same.
Even though you catch the core, you have to connect in various aspects. Then only you will be shared with the thing. Otherwise, you will be unnecessarily caught in many circumstances. So if you are connected the core is important, but you have to have some connection with other things. For example, somebody may have some doubt about karma or rebirth or anything, or some action in their day-to-day life, why husband and wife problem, so many problems they may have. So in each respect, you will have some different, external and internal. What is the relationship between the external and internal? So on various ground we have to discuss. Sometimes we may have some doubt and confirmation we have to have. So we will have a topic related to the confirmation. So everything is a good thing. Then only we will have a comprehensive idea about the neutral. The main thing is the same. There is no doubt about it. But we have a comprehensive idea about the thing. For that, we have to discuss various aspects in relation to that. It is discussed.
It is again bringing to the core. You are trying to bring to the core that it is
accepted. Yeah, in various aspects.
Yeah, once the person will accept that state has come, that means, yes, I am accepting everything, then nothing is needed. That's what you need to say.
Yeah.
Until that time, you need all this success.
I found myself in many situations trying to observe it and see how the understanding fits into it, how the external world circumstances and my reaction and it's kind of observation of what is happening. But what is the difference between this and between applying the understanding? Because it's a very subtle difference between them, because it's very close to try to apply the understanding to their circumstances. So
here, anyway, we have to aware of the situation, aware of the happening in ourselves. It is natural, and we can understand the functioning of our mind in relation to the circumstances. Everything, there is no wrong. But the stand, if you do not take any stand to correct ourselves psychologically, and if you do not take any stand like this, the matter is over. We need not worry about the other kind of tension, other kind of watching. That is not, you need not worry about that. It is also natural. It is not against this understanding.
இந்த சமயத்தில் உங்களுக்கு எண்ணங்கள் வந்து போகுதா, இல்லை நீங்கள் சும்மாவே உட்காந்துக்கிட்டா, இல்லை வெற்றிடமாக இருக்கா, எண்ணம் மட்டும் தனியாக இருக்கா,
எப்படி இருக்குன்னு எதிர்பார்த்துருக்கீங்க? நீங்கள் எதோ எதிர்பார்ப்பு வச்சுருக்கீங்க, நீங்கள் என்ன எதிர்பார்த்துருக்கீங்க?
நான் எதிர்பார்க்கறது வந்து
ஒன்றும் இருக்காதுன்னு
வெற்றிடமாக இருக்கும்.
நான் அப்படியே இருக்கேன்.
நம்மளுக்கு அது மாதிரி நீங்கள்
அப்படியே இருக்காங்க.
நான் சொல்கிறது
அது நீங்களே என்ன
உங்களுக்குள்ள என்ன இருக்கு
அது மாதிரி வரும் ஓட வரும் ஓடுன்னா நீங்க அமைதியா அழகாட்டீங்க. நான் இங்க பாக்குறது அங்க பாக்குறது அங்க வருது என்ன வருது
அவரு பாத்துட்டு
அவரு
பாத்துட்டு நீ பாத்துட்டு அது நீங்க பார்க்க மாட்டீங்க.
எனக்கு எண்ணங்கள் வந்து போயிட்டே இருக்கிறது புடிச்சிருந்தேன்.
நான் எண்ண கேள்வின்னு பதில் வரல.
Why I ask this question is, I attended a camp, a conference,
by Jim Bosker for 5 days. But there also is, he has his own way of putting this thing, what you're talking. But he also recommends you our ideas and all those things. But more than that, okay, there is something to follow there. More than that, this understanding has very, in a large way, helped me to resolve so many. Though it is a product of Hiral Bhaskar following some the food, how to consume my food and stuff, but still, on top of it, this understanding has really helped me to in fact, it is more than the physical thing. This mental faculty has helped me, that's what my feeling, my conclusion, has helped me in a large way to resolve many problems. Like sometimes I feel the sleeplessness, all this previously. See, he has given some reasons, but now really I'm not fighting with that sleeplessness. Suppose if there's sleeplessness exists, okay, this, I understand that it is due to some physical curing it is happening, but still my mental faculty is very dominant. Okay, it is there, so you do some work. When the sleep comes, let us sleep. So this this mental decision has helped me in a large, very profound way to come over many problems in my life, which has happened recent, like 3-4 years. Yeah, my relationship with my family, close family members, and relatives, with the friends. So it has really, I'm able to connect well, so without any deficiency, difference. Still, we are not solving the differences of opinion, but still, with the difference of opinion, still we are able to move with friends in our. We do not want, since I do not want to solve anything there, let it be that. Let it be like peaceful nature. I have my problem arising. Is it true?
Apply the understanding to what?
To somebody else.
So?
That becomes an expectation.
Understanding is
personal. Yeah, very personal.
It is not outside.
Yes.
Understanding is related very to our mind. So what I am telling is not, but externally, that is different. How to manage the things is different. But how to manage ourselves is what we are trying to say. Through understanding, we are
dealing with the initial stages, we had that, many of us, we had that difficulty. We have that freedom. Okay, why don't my friend or whatever close relative, let him also understand that. Then you can see that friction happens. Then Jnana Yoga or something like that. Is it? Our thing is
actually,
there is life and of course Karma Yoga is there.
Process of inquiry.
Okay.
This is
encouraging. And there is one more discipline called Bhakti Yoga. Why you are not is there any importance attached to it? Why you are not attaching any importance to it? Finding fault or whatever it is. But you are not you are not against it also. You are not against it also. But as a matter of fact, that can really give some additional support also.
So in case of bhakti, we have to go to the extent of surrender.
Yeah.
Then only it will be.
Yes.
Then the main thing is that we have to liberation. We have to get the liberated mind. They can be had only through the devotion itself. But here the main thing is that we have to, in the case of surrender, that means we are putting down all the responsibility. But the physical responsibility is not mentioned in the physical. Psychological responsibility must be away from physical responsibility. But in case of surrender, we cannot distinguish inner and outer, external and internal, psychological and physical. But here alone, only in the inquiry process alone, we can divide our way, the psychological and physical. So here we can withhold our, we can withdraw all our psychological duty. So in this case of self, they are free from any duty. Because we are giving all the responsibility in the hands of God, they don't have any work on their part. So they say in that level everything meet.
But as now we are talking about a reality. I mean, Nanamarga also.
Oh,
we are talking about the reality of the mind, how it functions.
The liberation has to
liberation
is
I but still the world exists for me. What I have to do with the, see, this external world, I am not created, see, this psychology, so I am not taking the responsibility to correct or to rectify the thing with respect to the psychological world. But that is, what do you call it, confusions, all the stuff still exists in this world. It looks very physical, like my body also it looks very physical. Who has created this? Don't I want to know something about that also?
So, if the main thing is either the psychological...
Somebody has created me, so then somebody should have created this world also. So, what is this relation between me and this world?
So, for that you can have some extra sensory perception. By getting some extra sensory perception, you may have some better knowing. So, what is the creation, the cosmic law, and the
not this ordinary mind cannot know.
Cannot understand. And but that is not necessary.
Not necessary. That is I accept that. But
for ourselves, the enlightenment liberation is the best thing.
Once it has happened, he is not enjoying everything.
But in the, if you develop the extra sensory perception, it may face many problems. So it is also having some problem. So we think you should not attach only good thing alone. Some bad thing alone is attached to the extra sensory perception. So we must be careful with that.
It's almost time tomorrow. We can talk something about attachment and detachments. Is it okay for me? No.
Attachment, detachment for.
No. Can you expand on this?
So
what is
attachment means? So the external world is concerned. If you don't have any attachment, you cannot do anything. So you have to attach some for yourself. You can rely upon something. Then only you can act. You can take some responsibility. So you have to have a responsible position with related to the external world. Then only you can act. Then only you can perform. For that, attachment is necessary. But if you have the same rule, you apply the same rule to the psychological world, where we attach something, I want to be always in a good state, I should not have in a bad state, and then you always resurrect some attachment. So here we are taking our attachment, create some responsibility. So
you take the irresponsible position.
So psychologically, you must take a irresponsible
position.
So it is quite opposite. So whenever we want to take a responsible position, so this attachment is necessary.
But
so
still, with respect to attachment, see, external world only, I attach. But still, that is whatever, when I attach with my family, with my father, with my siblings, with my son, with my... So, when there is no understanding, then that is creating a lot of problems with the...
So, psychologically, you must be free. Then only you will have some better meaning in the attachment itself. So, if you are psychologically free, in one way you are detached, so irresponsible, but in the physically you are responsible, it will have your responsibility have a different meaning. So, if you are psychologically, you are not all right, and physically you have some attachment, then the attachment is not a good one. It may create some more wrong in the external world itself. So it will have a different meaning, different relevance.
Thank you.
Because it seems there, that point of attachment. Say there's attachment to a child or a grandchild, something like that. When there's attachment, then if something happens to that child, say they die or something like that, then it seems that as a result of that attachment, and the person dies, then there's going to be pain as a result of it naturally. So then we're saying now we have to deal with the psychological state. So in that state, then it's just a matter of, okay, the pain is there, that's natural, so just accept it.
Well, don't accept the natural happening of the mind. So when you accept the natural happening of the mind, you will have a different kind of mind.
Right.
So that is a liberated kind of mind. So in the liberated kind of mind, anything can may come. But whatever comes will go away very soon. So that's the thing.
Yeah. So even the pain as a result of the, say, the death of the child will go away very soon?
Oh, yeah. Naturally, some pain will be there. There is no harm by getting some pain. So whatever comes to your liberated mind, it may take the form of pain or pressure, anything that may come. It doesn't matter. But it will solve itself. It will be in the natural flow.
Yeah, you know, in the state of this, you know, not existing, I understand everything, you know, I am very clear, my clarity of understanding is perfect, all this stuff. Suddenly, due to some unforeseen circumstances, see, emotionally, I have done something wrong, okay? Something wrong with person of the opposite sex, okay? So, now the whole thing becomes a very big, like it creates a lot of disturbance, all the stuff inside, okay? But the other person has she takes it, she doesn't take as a revenge, but still she, accepts it, and she asks me some key questions, and she leaves away from the scene, okay? But I've become very emotional, and in the spot of a second, I did that mistake. Now, how to overcome from this situation? Suppose this is, I'm imagining a situation and asking a solution. But suppose in case somebody is asking a question like this, is there any salvation in this?
So here, in case of some addiction to liquor or anything,
okay.
The same thing. So whenever we are carried out by some emotions or anything, you are taken away by your emotion. So that is a case of addiction. In case of addiction,
I am all right all the time. I am all right. That moment, I have lost my stability. See, that is not a regular happening. So all of a sudden, I have done something which cannot be accepted by family. When I look back, even I cannot accept myself in that situation.
So here, we have to take in the external world is concerned because some deeds are there. So we have to have a correct deed. So whenever we are it's related to ourselves alone, there is no problem. When it is related to the other person also, we have to take a perfect role. But if we have a correct understanding, concerning the other person as a concerning the average person, apart from that you are in a good position because you have the better understanding comparing with the ordinary person. So you can have a more chance to behave a good person just like
this. This should not have happened. That is one scenario. But
so it is in our hand because in the external world is concerned. An average person may be very easily carried by the emotion, but the person who has got a proper understanding may not be so easily carried by the emotion. So you can easily manage the situation.